8:20 on WBAL News Radio 1090. Bryan Nehman with you on this Tuesday morning. It is tax day. Peter Franchot, kind enough to join us here in studio, Comptroller of Maryland. A happy tax day to you, right?
I guess Bryan, thank you. Yeah, I'm probably the only person that actually likes tax day.
I was going to say.
That's my job, and my 1,200 employees are very busy today and looking forward to answering any last-minute panicked requests from Marylanders to, you know, they want to do the right thing, pay their taxes. Sometimes they freeze up, can't understand the forms, or they're just, forgetful or whatever. We try to open up our doors and let people know that we're on their side.
It is amazing to me that people do wait till the last minute to do these things. I guess they do. But do we have an idea of what the numbers are of people who wait till today in order to get that thing in the mail?
Yeah, we've processed about 2.5 million returns. Most of those people get refunds back from us, so they file early. They expect the money. It's very helpful to them. Well, I think we returned over $2 billion in refunds to Marylanders. So that's a real shot in the arm for the economy, and that's the reason a lot of folks have already filed. The folks that are filing today, a couple of 100,000 or more, are folks that we owe that owe money to us. And
right.
Generally, they like to
hold on to their money,
procrastinate and drag their feet. But there are a whole bunch of people, Bryan, that get just paralyzed because they don't get the tax system. They're just not equipped. Maybe they've gotten older, so they're just less able to navigate the system. And we tell them to call our 800-MD-TAXES, taxes number, and they'll get a live, friendly, professional person on the phone that will help them sort things out. If they have to file for an extension today, okay. They can still file electronically up until midnight. Great. Don't panic and don't assume that we're the IRS. We're not.
All right. I wanted to ask you about that because I had the Equifax breach earlier, I guess it was last year, and there are a lot of numbers and Social Security numbers that are out there. There's been a lot of concern from many different consumer groups saying, you got to be careful about your taxes. I mean, what should people be concerned about regarding fraud, especially with all the breaches that we have seen over the last several months, if not years?
Well, we've blocked, for example, 88,000 fraudulent requests for refunds totaling $190 million.
You've blocked them?
Yes, we've blocked them, have not sent them out. We are beginning to prosecute some of those people that we can identify, tax preparers who are pop-up frauds at tax time, or people that are just filing electronically because most of the returns are filed electronically. It's a big cottage industry, and we've figured out more or less how to prevent the Treasury from being robbed. We're just beginning to prosecute some of the people.
Interesting. Have you seen, I mean, can you compare that number to, say, a couple of years ago? I mean, that seems like a ton of money, $80 million that has been blocked.
Well, it's, it's over like the last 6 or 7 years total. But yeah, this is a constant problem. People that should be concerned about their financial information because so many companies and agencies have been hacked. And I just work under the assumption that somebody illegal out there has my Social Security number and has my W-2 information. And you just have to be vigilant and make sure that whoever's dealing with your taxes, for example, is honest if it's not yourself. And if you don't feel that your tax preparer is totally legit, get the heck out of there.
Talking with Peter Franchot, State Comptroller. You also get a pretty good idea about this time of year of where the Maryland economy is, right? These numbers that come in, the revenues we're getting from not only individuals but for businesses. Where would you say we are? What is the state of the economy in Maryland right now?
We're going to end up with about $3 billion in tax refunds. The federal tax cut's going to add another $2 billion into the state's economy this calendar year. So we anticipate that the economy is going to get a real shot in the arm from this injection of money into consumers' pockets. But overall, I would say the economy is, like the national economy, the jury's still out because we're just not sure that we've got long-term sustainable job and wage growth. I hope we do. Mm-hmm. I'm optimistic about the state. It's, running pretty well right now. But I'm not ecstatic about what the future holds. There are a lot of uncertainties out there.
In years past, though, you've used the term anemic. It's not quite
yes,
that bad.
I would not use anemic now. I'd say it's turbocharged, but you know, turbocharge tends to create its own problems.
Burnout,
inflation. Mm. You know, gosh knows what's going on around the world, trade wars and things like that. There are all sorts of uncertain things that could happen that we can't really predict. Obviously, I want everything to work out right, but I would urge the legislature, the governor, and anybody, all the county officials, just to be very cautious on the fiscal side.
All right, last question before I let you go, because the Supreme Court is hearing a case regarding sales tax and the internet, and whether or not these companies have to charge sales tax to places that don't have brick-and-mortar stores in those states. What is your stance on that? Should Marylanders have to pay sales tax on products that they buy out of a company that is not based in the state at all?
Absolutely. I mean, it's unpatriotic for people to go down and shop in bricks and mortar stores and then walk out of there and order over the internet, supposedly because they don't pay the 6% sales tax. I hope the Supreme Court makes the right decision and rules that all of these behemoth companies outside of Maryland must collect and remit to me as comptroller the 6% sales tax where it applies. Otherwise, our Main Street stores are just going to go out of business.
What about like when you go to Delaware and you buy, you know, a television or something like that, which does happen a lot? They don't have any sales tax.
But we compete very easily with Delaware because they have all sorts of hidden taxes that people don't realize. So the products are not necessarily that much cheaper. And plus, you know, who wants to live in Delaware? Let's live in Maryland.
we'll leave it there on that point. State Comptroller Peter Franchot, great to have you here as always. Appreciate you coming on the show.
Thanks, Bryan.